Ganoderma lucidum, the spirit mushroom, the mushroom of immortality, whatever you want to call it, reishi is cool. Not only in the medicinal properties that it has, but also in the way that it grows. I have a few reishi blocks here that are growing in some wacky ways, so I thought it'd be fun to show you what's going on. Reishi is a medicinal mushroom, or a functional mushroom, and not a culinary mushroom. So normally when it's grown for medicinal purposes, it looks something like this. There are lots of different ways that you can grow reishi, but typically it's grown outside in greenhouses or shade houses on real deal logs that are buried under a thin layer of dirt underground. This way takes a long time, like 9 months basically, from the time that you inoculate the log to the time that you're actually harvesting the reishi. But since it's grown outdoors with lots of fresh air, it grows these nice, beautiful, perfectly shaped reishi mushroom conchs. Now, I actually did this on another video on a way smaller scale. I built this mini backyard greenhouse where we took some reishi blocks and we buried them and allowed them to grow in the greenhouse. And it was a really cool way to grow reishi and kind of mimic that natural cultivation process. So if you want to check that video out, go ahead and do that up here. You see, reishi, similar to any other mushroom basically, can look completely different depending on the conditions that it grows in, specifically the amount of carbon dioxide that is in the environment or the level of oxygen that's in the environment. So when reishi has a high carbon dioxide concentration, it will grow in these finger-like projections and these little skinny mushrooms, and that's called the reishi in its antler form. But if it has enough fresh air or high enough oxygen concentration, it will form this conch form, and that's important because reishi will want to grow until it feels like there's enough oxygen, and eventually it will produce these porous surfaces on the bottom of the conch that will release its spores and float through the air and hopefully reproduce. And reishi really does produce a ton of spores, billions of spores. And if you ever see reishi mushroom being cultivated in these greenhouses, when they're sporulating, they will have like an inch thick layer of spores on top of the mushroom. It's just crazy how much spores these things can actually produce. So here we have some bags with a reishi growing inside them, and I want to show you exactly what this antler form is like. As you can see, they're growing in these bags, and you can imagine that they're not getting a lot of fresh air. And remember, mushrooms breathe just like we do, so they take in oxygen and breathe out CO2. So if they're stuck inside this bag, they're going to be in a high CO2 environment. So let's take these off and let's take a look. So here you can see the antler form of the reishi mushrooms growing, and this one has a bunch of different ones growing. It's not always like that. And in fact, when it's being cultivated on logs, oftentimes they will pick off a number of antlers and just leave one of them to grow so it can form those single, beautiful looking fruiting bodies. But still, here's a bunch of different antlers. And what's so cool about this is just the different striations of color. So we have the nice kind of deep reds and the oranges and the yellows. And if you look right at the tippity top of the reishi antler, you can see it's got like a nice white leading edge, and that's how you can tell that the reishi mushroom is still growing. And this leading edge is what will eventually turn into those conchs. So eventually, if it gets enough fresh air, like if I were to take the bag out and just leave it kind of like this, eventually that would start to grow out and form that beautiful conch shape. Again, not all cultivators will do it where they grow those big mushrooms. Some will just leave them inside of the bag and grow the mushroom entirely in its antler form, which is a perfectly reasonable thing to do. This is another one here, and as you can see, it was just kind of one antler. And if you look really closely, you can see that it started to round out and turn brown and turn into that spore-bearing surface. But then for whatever reason, it decided to just grow another antler just off of that thing. So I don't know why it did that. And you can see another tiny little antler here, but it doesn't really matter because eventually this part will then turn into the reishi conch, or the surface that allows the mushrooms to spread its spores. And it just is another way to see that, you know, mushrooms grow in all sorts of wacky ways, take on all sorts of different shapes, fold over itself, just do whatever it has to do to get the spores out of the fruiting body. The other thing that is notable about reishi is the mycelium. The mycelium of reishi is, in my opinion, one of the most beautiful of all the mushroom myceliums. It's absolutely stark white, it's really smooth and super tenacious, and it just looks like a perfectly clean sheet of freshly laid snow. And specifically, when you compare it to something like lion's mane, which is kind of like cotton candy, if you touch it, it kind of dissolves, it's really fluffy. Reishi is just pure white, and it's also really tough. Even, for example, if you try to cut it with a scalpel, you kind kind of have a hard time getting through this mushroom, and not a lot of mycelium is like this. And it would be kind of interesting to see something like if we took a little bit of lion's mane and a little bit of reishi and put them on the same plate and allowed them to battle it out and see which one would win. I can almost guarantee you it would be the mycelium of reishi. Even though the mycelium is so white, the actual reishi fruiting block will sometimes form kind of a brown crust or a brown outer layer. And a lot of people, when they're growing reishi, they will think this is contamination, but it's totally normal. It's just kind of like a protective crust that the reishi grows on top of the fruiting block to protect its mycelium as it's producing these fruiting bodies. And the other thing that you might see on a reishi fruiting block, or when you're growing any type of mushroom really, is what are called metabolites. So these are like little pools of liquid. Sometimes they're orange. And again, quite often people think these are contamination, but really this is just reishi flexing its immune system and producing very specific things to protect itself against potential pathogens like bacteria or other fungi. And it's kind of a really interesting area of research actually, where researchers are taking pieces of mushroom mycelium, putting them on an agar dish with a specific pathogen, something like Staphylococcus bacteria, for example, allowing the mycelium to grow towards that pathogen. And when it comes in contact with it, it will produce a metabolite that is specifically antibacterial towards it. So it's kind of an interesting area of research where they're thinking, hey, maybe we can use mushrooms to produce very specific antibiotics, antifungals, and even antivirals by using this technique, by using the knowledge and the power of mushrooms. As mentioned before, reishi is ridiculously tenacious, and once it gets going, it's almost hard not to grow this mushroom. In fact, when we were making these blocks, the grain spawn we were using was super old and it was way too consolidated to get it out of the jar, so we had to dig it out with a spoon and put it in this block, and it wasn't really sterile like you'd like to typically grow mushrooms, but it didn't seem to matter because, again, reishi just wants to grow. It just seems to destroy everything in its path, including contamination, but also including physical barriers, which makes sense, right? Because when you think about it, reishi grows on logs, it'll burst through the cracks in wood, but it will also burst through all sorts of other things. And this is kind of what's happening in this block, which is what I wanted to show you. This one I thought was really cool because, as you can see, the mycelium just ripped right up the side of the bag. And once it got there, it changed course. All of a sudden it fruited an antler and headed right through the filter as if it knew it was there. Like, are these mushrooms sentient or something? I mean, sometimes I honestly think that mushrooms have a brain just like we do. But either way, you can see that it headed right for the filter, and it will just grow right through this filter. Nothing will stop it. I've seen this happen before where it just forms a big, beautiful conch right on the outside of this filter. You don't have to open the bag. You don't have to do anything. The reishi will find a way to grow. In fact, I even remember seeing a Reddit post one time. It was posted on r what is this thing, where people post pictures of things. They have no idea what they are, and people chime in. But anyways, it was something that was pulled out of a toilet by a plumber, and it was about this big, and it really did look like an antler form of a reishi mushroom that happened to be growing from inside of the toilet. And of course, there's no way to know for sure that this is reishi mushroom, but by looking at the picture, it's almost undeniable that it is reishi mushroom that just wanted to grow and for whatever reason found its way into the drain of a toilet and eventually burst its way through. So again, this mushroom is super tenacious. It's one of the most beautiful mushrooms in all the different ways that it can grow. It's also a powerful medicinal mushroom, which we should never forget, because really that's the real reason why people cultivate reishi mushroom, is to be used for medicinal purposes. But either way, no matter why you're growing it, it's still really fun to see it and all the wacky different ways that it can grow. So that's it for this video, but if you've ever grown reishi mushroom yourself, I'd love to know what you think of growing reishi. Let me know in the comments below. And until then, we will see you in the next video. Do you want to become a functional mushroom expert? I've got just the thing for you. It's a new ebook called Mushroom Powered: The History, the Science, and the Benefits of the World's Most Fantastic Fungi. At over 130 pages, it's absolutely packed with all the information you need to know to learn about the world's most powerful medicinal mushrooms. And the best part, it's 100% free. You can download it right now. Just click the link in the description, enter your email address, and I will send it to you right away. I hope you love it.